Okay, in this video, we want to discuss how can we extract information about the average, about the dispersion, skewness, and kurtosis from moments. Since we know that there are three types of moments, that is mean moments, raw moments, and moments about origin. So in the previous video, we discussed that how can we calculate mean moments. So these are the formulas which can be used to compute mean moments. Now the first question is, how can we extract information regarding average from mean moments? So we know that it is mandatory to calculate mean first for the mean moment. So mean is already calculated from over here. So x bar is equal to, for ungrouped data, it is equal to summation x divided by n, and for group data, this is equal to summation fx divided by summation x square. So this is mean. All right. Next, we need information about dispersion. Before further discussion, you guys are requested to like this video, subscribe to Show Academy, and press the bell icon to get regular updates of this channel. That M2, if you, for ungrouped data, if you are calculating M2, or for group data, you are using this formula to calculate M2. Both these formulas gives you the results of the variance of the data, or you can call it S square. So this is the variance. The third information which we need from the mean moments is about skewness. So skewness, this value gives us information about the skewness, but this is absolute skewness. Summation x minus x bar cube divided by n for ungrouped data, and this formula for group data. This gives us skewness, but this is absolute skewness. For relative skewness, we calculate B1. B1 is the first mean moment ratio, and this is equal to M3 square divided by M2 cube. So M2 is already computed over here. This is M2, and M3 is calculated by this formula. And this is always positive. This is greater than zero. This value can be less than zero, it can be greater than zero, or it can be equal to zero. And this tells us whether the distribution is negatively skewed, positively skewed, or it is symmetrical, right? But B1 is always positive. The reason is M3 can be negative or positive, but when you take the square of M3, it becomes positive. And M2 is variance is always positive. So if you are taking its power cube, it will be a positive. So the ratio of two positive value is always a positive value. So B1 is always positive, but it is in relative term, it gives you the value of the skewness, that is in percentage form. Okay, but how would we know the direction of skewness, whether it is negative or it is positive? So we will look into the sign of M3. If it is zero, then distribution will be symmetrical and both the tails of the distribution will be equal. If it is greater than zero, I mean if it is positive, then the distribution will be positively skewed, and which means that the left and the right hand tail of the distribution is longer. And if the value of M3 is negative, then it means that the left hand tail of the distribution is longer and it is negatively skewed. So this is how to extract information regarding skewness from the third mean moment. And next you need kurtosis. For kurtosis, we calculate the second moment ratio, which is equal to B2. B2 is equal to M4 divided by M2 square. And it can be equal to 3, and it can be greater than 3, or it can be less than 3. So we have to calculate M4, and it should be divided by M2 square, and we have to look into its value. If the answer of B2 is equal to 3, then it means that the distribution is normally peaked, it is mesocortic. And if it is greater than 3, then the distribution is more highly peaked, and it will be leptocortic. However, if the value of B2 is less than 3, then the distribution will be platycortic. For mesocortic, the dispersion is normal. For leptocortic, dispersion is minimal. But for platycortic, the dispersion is too much. It should be noted. So this is how to extract information from the mean moments regarding the mean, variance, skewness, and kurtosis. Next, how can we extract information about the mean, variance, skewness, and kurtosis from the raw moments? All right. So first of all, we need to calculate all these first four raw moments. Mean in this case, mean is equal to the mode value A plus M1 prime. If we need mean from the first mean moment, it is equal to A, the provisional mean, the mode value, it is A, right? What is A? It is the mode value or any value with respect to which you have calculated the first four raw moments. So the first raw moments plus the A, the sum of these two gives you the arithmetic mean. For variance, you calculate M2, and M2, you know, this is equal to M2 prime minus M1 prime square. This is equal to M2. It gives you the value of variance, which we have already calculated here. This is M2, M2 prime minus M1 prime square. Then you need to calculate M3 and M4 by these formulas. You have already calculated M3 prime, M1, M2, all these raw moments. Convert them into mean moments, and then you got the value of mean, you got the value of variance. For sinus, again you need M3. The interpretation of M3 is as this one, right? This is the relative skewness and this is the absolute skewness. The interpretation is as it is. And for M4, you need to calculate, for kurtosis, you need to calculate B2. Again, the same thing. You need to calculate M4 and M2. M4 divided by M2 square, look at its value. If it is equal to 3, distribution will be mesocortic. Greater than 3, it will be leptocortic. And if it is less than 3, distribution will be platycortic. So, again, you also need to calculate B1, which is equal to M3 square divided by M2 cube, and M3 can be equal to 0, it can be greater than 0, and it can be less than 0, but this is always greater than 0. This gives you the value of skewness in percentage form, and M3 gives you the value of skewness in absolute form. It is always greater than 0, and it can be equal to 0, it can be less than 0, it can be greater than 0. If it is equal to 0, then the distribution is symmetrical, both the tail of the distribution will be equal. If it is greater than 0, then the distribution will be positively skewed. If M3 is less than 0, the distribution will be negatively skewed. And so you need B2, which is equal to M4 divided by M2 square. If it is equal to 3, a distribution will be mesocortic. If it is greater than 3, the distribution will be leptocortic, and if it is less than 3, the distribution will be platycortic. Alright, if you want to extract information from the moments about origin, then note that M1 prime is directly equal to the arithmetic mean, because this is the direct formula for the arithmetic mean. And for variance, you need to calculate M2. M2 is equal to this formula, M2 prime minus M1 prime square. Yeah, M2 prime minus M1 prime square. So it is equal to variance. Then you need to calculate M3 and M4 by these formulas, right? And if you need skewness, this is equal to M3 square divided by M2 cube, and it is always greater than 0, and M3 can be equal to 0, it can be greater than 0, and it can be less than 0. Similarly, for kurtosis, you need to calculate B2, the second moment ratio, which is equal to M4 divided by M2 square. The interpretation is as above moments about the raw moment, sorry. The rest of the interpretation of the moments about origin and raw moments is similar. We will do a numerical example on how we calculate mean moments directly, moments about origin and raw moments, and how can we convert the raw moments and moments about origin to the mean moments. We will do it in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.